To continue the development of the offshore oil and gas fields in Malaysia, a fourth gas processing plant had to be constructed in Kertih on the east coast of Malaysia. The erection work of the major heavy lifts for this GPP-4 plant was awarded to Van Zomer in Southeast Asia with its headquarters in Singapore. As the heaviest piece that had to be placed on foundation weighed as much as 350 tons, Van Zomeren mobilized one of its 800 tons D-Mac CC 4800 crane. This giant machine was dismantled in Palembang, Indonesia, where it just completed another contract and was loaded on two flat-top heavy lift barges and towed to a temporary jetty in the Pakar River on the east coast of Malaysia. The barge with the boom sections and counterweight was discharged in the nearby port of Kemaman. All foundations at the job site were ready to receive the heavy pieces. The supervisor instructed his rigging crew, and within 4 days two crawler cranes were rolled off from the barge and partly dismantled in order to transport them over the road to the job site. A steel crane, a 225 tons crawler crane, was mobilized on the same barge. This crane assisted in rigging the 800 tons D-Mac. The CC 4800, which was 12.5 meters wide, was slowly rolled off and crawled its way up on the jetty. The access road on the jetty even had to be widened and proved just wide enough for this giant. Two enormous tracks of more than 12 meters long and a width of 2 meters each spread the weight of the crane on the ground. Additional supports between the tracks can hydraulically be activated and reduce the ground load even more. Now boat tracks were taken off in order to transport a main car body of 150 tons by road to the job site. An 8-axle-line Cometo platform trailer was used to carry the car body to site, which was 8 kilometers down the road. The crawler tracks, each of 84 tons, were transported on separate low loaders. To transport the complete crane with superlift attachment and all boom sections, more than 60 trailer loads were required. With the help of a 220 tons American hoist crane, the 800 tons CC 4800 slowly began to take shape. First, the 42 meter long superlift mast was rigged. followed by the 92-meter main boom. An experienced rigging crew created the 800-ton crane from all these parts within only 4 days. At the same time, preparations were made on the heavy lift barge to receive the first shipment of heavy lifts at the port of Kamamon. Final plans were discussed, and a few days before ship's arrival, the CC4800 was ready to erect the first heavy lifts. At the rear end of the crane, a special superlift bogie was installed. In this way, the maximum ground pressure was reduced to less than 10 tons per square meter. On the 12th of May, Jumbo's heavy lift vessel Mirabella arrived in the port of Kamamon. As the biggest columns were too large and too heavy for the 42 kilometers long route to the job site, Jumbo had planned to transport these items in 3 consecutive barge trips from Kamamon to Paka. The lighter and smaller items were transported via the road to the Kerte job site. 3 columns of 200 tons, 220 tons and 105 tons respectively were placed on steel supports on board of the heavy lift barge NY1 and secured for the towage along the coast. At the Paka River entrance, the barge could only enter at high water level with the assistance of local fishing boats and a shallow draft tug. Safely, the first barge arrived at the Roro jetty and was ballasted aground. Lashings were taken off and preparations were made to roll off with the 2 columns, one directly followed by the other. It was the Malaysian transport contractor Shapadu who carried all heavy lifts to site. Jumbo Shipping was responsible for the overall planning and engineering of the shipping, barging and transport. All this as a subcontractor of the local Malaysian forwarder Container National. It was the Korean contractor Hyundai Engineering and Construction who was responsible for the construction of the gas processing plant and who awarded the erection contract to Van Zomeren Southeast Asia. A set of 5 Exoline Cometo trailers equipped with turntables were used to carry the 220 tons heavy and 61 meter long column. Another column of 105 tons followed directly after the first one on a second set of trailers. Exactly as planned, the 61-meter-long stainless steel column was maneuvered from the main road onto the job site. With a large overhang, the front dolly, a 12-meter-long drawbar was needed to clear the base ring with the prime mover. Under expert supervision, both columns were safely maneuvered onto the job site under reach of the D-Max CC4800. A steel crane, 225 tons American hoist was placed on the path of crane mats, and the CC4800 was rigged in a central location with 92 meters main boom and superlift. From this position it could erect all columns from this shipment. The first column was placed on supports and fitted with ladders and platforms. At a radius of 30 meters the CC4800 lifted the second column of 105 tons from the transporters. The American hoist lifted the base ring, and in a continuous operation of less than half an hour, the column was erected from horizontal into vertical position. The tail crane was disconnected and the CC4800 with superlift bogey turned slowly into the direction of the foundation and boomed out to 41 meter radius and exactly positioned the column over its foundation bolts. The whole operation was carried out under expert supervision of an experienced Dutch erection superintendent. The smaller items were carried from the port of Kamaman by road over a distance of 42 kilometers to the job site and erected in a similar way. Depending on the weight of the column, the superlift counterweight was taken off or increased. The heaviest reactor that was lifted weighed 350 tons. From this central location in the plant, the CC4800 crane could erect the majority of all columns.